آله وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. اللهم اجعل تجمعنا هذا تجمعا مرحوما وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما إنك ولي ذلك والقادر عليه. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وأزواجه الطاهرات وعلى من تبعهم بإحسان يوم الدين. اللهم آمين. أما بعد, we are still speaking about the story of the Israelites. And just a quick reminder of the slew of events that are mentioned in the ayat that we touched upon in the past several sessions, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds the Israelites, Bani Israel, of the many, many endless favors that He bestowed upon them, and how He preferred them with His revelations, with His sending of the messengers and the prophets over many other people, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds them of His favors upon them when He saved them from the Pharaoh and his mala' and his soldiers, and how He saved His their children and their spouses from the abuse that they were receiving and the slaughter of the children. And then how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala split open the sea for them into 12 different alleys for them to walk through. And how the moment they've crossed the Red Sea and they saw a people worshipping idols, immediately requested Moses, peace be unto him, to make an idol for them just like these people. That's immediately after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved them and have allowed them to cross, the sea. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to Moses for the appointed time. And then when Moses, peace be unto him, went to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Israelites have gathered the jewelry and the gold that they have stolen from the Pharaoh and the respective families of the Pharaoh and his mala', his soldiers and the elite of the society. And they melted that with the, persuasion of a Samiri, to basically melt all this jewelry and create a calf, a calf with the jewelry. And then he said, هَذَا إِلَهُكُمْ وَإِلَهُ مُوسَى فَنَسِي. He told the Israelites that this is your God, this is your ilah, and this is the ilah of Moses as well. So when Moses returned from meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he says in Surah Taha, وَمَا أَعْجَلَكَ عَنْ قَوْمِكَ يَا مُوسَى قَالَهُمْ أَلَا عَلَى أَثَرِي وَعَجِلْتُ إِلَيْكَ رَبِّ لِتَرْضَى. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked Moses, peace be unto him, what have caused you to hasten to the meeting? And where are your people? قَالَهُمْ أَلَا عَلَى أَثَرِي. I've left them to come to you and I've hastened towards responding to the meeting that you called me for. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informs them that He has caused them a tribulation. قَالَ فَإِنَّا فَتَنَّا قَوْمَكَ مِنْ بَعْدِكَ وَأَضَلَّهُمُ السَّامِرِ. That we have, tested your people through this fitna. And the fitna, we said, is something good if you are successful in handling the fitna or the tribulation. And it's something bad if you fail the test, وَعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. So Moses, peace be unto him, returned to his people. And he was very angry. And in one narration, some of the other ayat in the Quran, that he threw the tablets that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him. And he took by the head of his brother. And in one ayat says by the beard of his brother. So he was very angry that they have done such a thing. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislated for them a system of guidance. وَذَاتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ وَالْفُرْقَانَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislated for Moses, peace be unto him, and his people. Al-Kitab means the divine book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wal-Furqan, that which distinguishes truth from falsehood. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it as a kafara for them that they kill each other. فَاقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Meaning that they would stand in two rows. Those who worship the calf would be the ones to be killed, and those who did not would be the ones who would kill. And then 70,000 of them approximately were killed, and then Moses and Aaron, alayhi salatu wasalam, they said, al-baqiyya, al-baqiyya, they began to supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, they're about to finish, let some of them remain. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded to the supplication of Moses alayhi salam. So after all of that, Musa alayhi salam goes to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala near Jabal al-Tur, the mountain of Tur, in the wadi, in the valley or the desert of Sina in Egypt. And he took 70 of the best, in other words, these are like the best of Bani Israel, 70 of the most righteous. And in one narration, the interpreters say that when Moses, peace be upon him, goes to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the clouds would descend upon the mountain to the extent that it will cover the mountain, it will cover Moses, peace be unto him. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would speak to Moses. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Moses, in the forehead of Moses, you will see such bright light that the normal human being cannot gaze at it, cannot, you know, stare at it. So some of the interpreters said that these 70 people as well were able to hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That see, these 70 people were able to hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I mentioned these two events to show that typically people of good conscience, of good intellect, would take heed from one incident after another, especially, you know, given, you know, the magnitude of these incidents that followed one another. So here, وَإِذْ قَالُوا يَا مُوسَىٰ لَن نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ, even after that, even after hearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, speak, قَالُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حَتَّى نَرَى اللَّهَ جَهْرًا. They said, we shall not believe in you, O Moses, until we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala eye to eye, face to face. You know, a blatant request that is conditioned by, in other words, this is not an iman. You do not lay rules and stipulations or prerequisites. I will only believe in you if you show me Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what's left there to believe in? What is left to believe in? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at the outset of this surah, he describes the believers by mentioning the first quality, الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ, that those who believe in al-ghayb, that which is unseen, unknown. So here, they are blatantly asking, demanding, and making it a prerequisite for them to believe in Moses, and all that he came with, is that they would see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was angry with them. فَأَخَذَتْكُمُ الصَّاعِقَةُ وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ. Then the sa'iqa, some interpreters said that the sa'iqa is a loud voice from the sky, and some said it's a fire. And it could be a combination of the two. Allah ta'ala a'la wa a'lam. وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ means that some of you are looking at one another. This group is dying, while this group is still alive. And then as this group comes back to life, right, the other group begins to die and come back to life while the second group is looking at them. وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ, and you are watching this process of dying and resurrection. Now, somebody may say, well, Musa alayhi salam also requested to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Israelites requested to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the difference between the two requests? The request of Musa alayhi salam, he said, قَالَ رَبِّ أَرِنِي أَنْظُرْ إِلَيْكَ. The word أَرِنِي means that enable me to see. Allow me to see when I look at you. So أَرِنِي أَنْظُرْ, أَرِنِي أَنْظُرْ means enable me, assist me to, because Moses, peace be unto him, knows the certainty of knowledge. He cannot see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why he said, أَرِنِي means that without your help, I will not be able to see you. أَرِنِي أَنْظُرْ إِلَيْكَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَالَ لَنْ تَرَانِي, you shall not be able to see me. وَلَكِنْ أُنْظُرْ إِلَى الْجَبَلِ, however, look at the mountain. فَإِنْ اسْتَقَرَّ مَكَانَهُ فَسَوْفَ تَرَانِي. If the mountain, which is the symbol of stability and greatness, if it stays put in its place, you will be able to see me. And if it does not, you will not be able to see me. And this is a tremendous act of mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَمَّا تَجَلَّى رَبُّهُ لِلْجَبَلِ, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala portrayed himself, partially, wholly, how, we don't know. In matters of ghayb, we do not go into the intricate details and the how question. فَلَمَّا تَجَلَّى رَبُّهُ لِلْجَبَلِ جَعْلَهُ دَكَّ, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala تجلى to this mountain, the mountain came tumbling down. When Moses, peace be unto him, saw this scene, he also came tumbling down. He went unconscious. فَلَمَّا أَفَاقَ, when Moses, peace be unto him, woke up, قال سبحانك. The first thing he said, سبحانك. سبحانك means that my request was not in place. You're way above anyone to ask to see you in the current form that they've been created in. So that's why, فَلَمَّا أَفَقْ, the first thing he said, سُبْحَانَكْ, and then he said what? تُبْتُ إِلَيْكْ, I repent to you that I've made such a request. And notice, like it's with utmost etiquettes and politeness. But yet, it's, and you know, he felt it's an inappropriate request. قَالَ سُبْحَانَكَ تُبْتُ إِلَيْكْ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. What does it mean for Musa alayhi salam to say, I'm the first of the believers? We had Adam alayhi salam. We had Nuh, we had other prophets and their followers. And أول المؤمنين, I'm the first of the believers that none can see you in their current form. In other words, inshallah, when we get to look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on Judgment Day, and we get to see Him in Jannah, we're not going to be in the physical form that we're in now. This eye, this sense that we have, will not be able to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates us in such a form, gives us such an eyesight that will enable us to see Him. That will enable us to see Him. So Musa alayhi salam said, سُبْحَانَكَ تُبْتُ إِلَيْكُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, I'm the first of the believers that none can see you in this life, in this world, in their current creation. Now that's the request of Moses, peace be unto him. Just like when Adam alayhi salam made a mistake and he repented immediately. Versus Satan insisted upon his ma'siyah. Now, the Israelites made it a condition. And notice, these are the best of the Israelites. 70 men from among the best of the Israelites. And if that is their request, and if that is their condition, and that's their prerequisites, to believe in Musa alayhi salam and that which was revealed to him, and to make it a condition, that is a very blatant and arrogant and defiant request. In fact, it's not a request, it's a demand. قَالُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ لَكْ, we shall not even believe in you and all that you've come with. حَتَّى نَرَى اللَّهَ جَهْرًا, until you show us Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala eye to eye, face to face. And that's why the punishment descended upon them, the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descended upon them immediately. فَأَخَذَتْكُمُ الصَّاعِقَةُ وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ. So the صَاعِقَة, this loud voice or this fire or combination of the two, has overtaken you and you died while you're looking at one another. ثُمَّ بَعَثْنَاكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَوْتِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Then Moses, peace be unto him, began to supplicate when he saw that the 70 best men of the Israelites, you know, have been, you know, sort of like caused to death and have been punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, oh Allah, أَفَتُهْلِكُنَا بِمَا فَعَلَ السُّفَهَاءُ مِنَّا. Oh Allah, you destroy us by way of the ignorant ones' behavior. Oh Allah, these are the best of them. If I was to go back to Bani Israel without the 70 best men, they're never going to believe in me. They're not going to follow anything. And he began to weep and cry. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded favorably to his, you know, request. And he resurrected them. ثُمَّ بَعَثْنَاكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَوْتِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Then we have resurrected you after you've been caused to die. Huh? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Perhaps you'll be grateful for one of these bounties that will achieve a level of iman that shall never be compromised again. وَأَنْزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَنَّ وَالسَّلْوَى. Then we have descended upon you al-man and al-salwa. Al-man al-salwa, the collective opinion of the scholars is that it's food and drink. Some of them went to, you know, some level of details as to what is this food and what is this drink. But, you know, there's, in spite of the, you know, differences of the opinion among the scholars, you know, they're in agreement that while the Israelites were in a state of teeth, you know, loss in the desert of Sina, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in spite of that, descended upon them al-man was-salwa. So this is like, you know, another bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As he says, وَضَلَّلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْغَمَامَ وَأَنْزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَنَّ وَالسَّلْوَى. كُلُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ وَمَا ظَلَمُونَا وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. So eat and drink. كُلُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Eat and drink from that which we have bestowed upon you from our bounties. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا ظَلَمُونَا. No one is in any position to cause injustice to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدٍ. And there's a rule in the interpretation of any words in the Quran or the Sunnah, is that if the root word is the same, ظلم means injustice. ظالم is an unjust person. ظلام, زيادة في المبنى, means that there's an increase in the letters to the same word, to the same root word. This is an exaggerated form of the word, meaning that it adds more to the meaning. Why would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describe himself as he's one who is not ظلام للعبيد, to the slaves? He's not one who causes tremendous injustice to the slaves. Does that mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala causes some level of injustice? Or perhaps, you know, a little bit of injustice and not so much? No. The scholars say that when we talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we all speak about him in the infinite terms. Why? Because for someone to be unjust, meaning that they have certain level of power to cause this injustice. You're not gonna find the weak oppressing the strong. You're not gonna find the poor oppressing the wealthy. It's always the other way around. The one that has power causes injustice to the one who has less power or no power. And the greater the level of power, the greater the ability to cause injustice. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the infinite ability to cause injustice to each and every one of us and all of his creation. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is beyond that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is beyond that. One with the infinite power, infinite ability, is certainly able to cause tremendous levels of injustice. Infinite levels of injustice. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the All High, is way above that. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا ظَلَمْنَاهُمْ. This is not an act of injustice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has done to the Israelites. Rather, they've done it to themselves. وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. How is that? By way of their arrogant behavior. By way of their defiance to the prophets and the messengers. By way of refusing to submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in spite of the many, many, many miracles and bounties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon them. This is just another portion of the slew of events that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala narrates for us in the Quran, as he tells us, نَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ أَحْسَنَ الْقَصَصِ. By way of us telling you the best of stories according to the account of justice, the account of truth. So these are not fairy tales, these are not, opinions, these are not anything but the statements of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to the account of al-haq, that which is infinite truth, that which is based on factual, truth of events that have taken place. وَمَا ظَلَمْنَاهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. They're the ones who are causing injustice to one another and to each other and to themselves, time over time over time. And inshallah, we'll continue with this story next session. So this way, each story has a segment that is an integral part of the slew of events, but again, it's independent in the sense that we can take one portion of it at a time, one portion at a time, and continue to tie these events just to show, if this teaches us anything, it shows the level of patience that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has upon his slaves. In spite of the fact that we sin day in and day out, and we have our shortcomings, and we make mistakes, and so on and so forth, the gates of mercy and the gates of tawbah are always wide open, are always wide open. This is a reminder for us. However, when the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes a person, it does not leave him. It does not unleash him. So this is an opportunity for us to aspire to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to think well of him. And part of thinking well of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to hasten towards tawbah, to hasten towards forgiveness, to hasten towards seeking istighfar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to hasten towards doing good deeds and righteous deeds, knowing that this window of opportunity can come to a closure at any given point. هذا والله تعالى أعلى وأعلم. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر فاستغفروه. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك، نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم اسألك الرضا بعد القضاء، وبرد الحياة بعد الممات، والنظر إلى وجهك الكريم في غير ضراء مضرة ولا فتنة مضلة، إنك ولي ذلك والقادر عليه. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وأزواجه الطاهرين وعلى التابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان يوم الدين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.